The Hollywood musical Meet Me in St. Louis, starring Judy Garland, opened in 1944, and it has remained a classic to this day. Have Yourself a Merry Little Christmas, The Boy Next Door, and The Trolley Song have certainly found a permanent place in our American songbook. These songs are among the most popular compositions of Hugh Martin, who Alec Wilder included in his list of great innovators. Born in 1914, Mr. Martin has collaborated with all of the other great writers featured in this series and has contributed enormously to our musical heritage. At the age of 90, he still maintains the joyful energy and enthusiasm of someone blessed to have done that which he loved the most. Hugh Martin grew up in Alabama and studied classical music at the Birmingham Conservatory of Music. His career seemed destined to follow that path until Hugh's mother brought home the score to Rhapsody in Blue. And that, as they say, was Hugh Martin's aha moment. He left Alabama for New York and began experiencing an almost magical success story.
I always wanted to go to New York. There wasn't any moment. There was never a moment when I didn't want to go to New York. My mother adored it, and I think it contagious itself to me. Mm-hmm. And she used to take me occasionally. She had to go on business, and she would take me, and we'd see the shows, and totally fell in love with the city. I lived there for 35 years.
What was it like in New York in the 30s and 40s?
It was almost unbearably exciting, to
I
tell
bet.
You the truth. The city itself was so thrilling. We used to walk in Central Park even at night. There was no crime, or very little to speak of. The streets were safe, and nobody locked his door much, and prices were low, and the shops were full of well-dressed ladies and gentlemen. It was just a very elegant city, and people dressed up to go to the theater, especially on opening nights. The audience was as much part of the show as the actors. It was a lovely time to live in New York.
I'm gonna be a shady ladybird. I got an awful lot to learn. But if you tell me that my heart's on fire, I'm gonna let it burn. I'm gonna be a shocking mockingbird. I'm gonna mingle with the best. I'm gonna try to find my heart's desire.
One thing is sure, the singers know the good songs, and it is through recordings like this with Peggy Lee and Benny Goodman of Hugh Martin and Ralph Blaine's Shady Ladybird that this music lives on. As Judy Garland's biographer and a close friend of Hugh Martin, writer John Fricke contends that the converse is true as well. Good songwriters recognize good singers, and the team of Ralph Blaine and Hugh Martin knew they had it good when they were matched up with Judy Garland.
Hugh and his writing partner, Ralph Blaine, first worked with Judy and Mickey Rooney when they were sent to New York by MGM to kick off the Manhattan premiere of Wizard of Oz at the Capitol Theater in 1939. You, for 50 cents or whatever the price of admission was, you got the Wizard of Oz first run, you got short subjects and cartoons and newsreel and trailers, and then you got a 35-minute live act with a 20-piece orchestra and Judy Garland and Mickey Rooney performing and singing live.
Wow.
But there was an 8-person vocal backup, a job for which Hugh and his group had auditioned. And Roger Edens, I believe, MGM's mainstay, is the one who gave them the job. And they sang a choral version of We're Off to See the Wizard, just, you know, something to kind of serve as the segue from the orchestra into Judy and Mickey. And Hugh was not aware of Judy at that point, and he said they stood in the wings to listen to a rehearse, and everybody just fell apart. Mm. That they were so astounded at the way this 17-year-old girl could sing, the sound she made, the emotion she had. And so when Hugh and Ralph got carted off to California about 3 years later to work on the movie version of Best Foot Forward, Arthur Freed brought them out. He was using their Broadway show for a movie musical and wanted them there. And then they immediately began to write other material. One of the first things they wrote was a song for Judy Garland to sing in the movie For Me and My Gal, this big rousing patriotic thing called Three Cheers for the Yanks.
Three cheers for the Yanks, for their planes and their tanks, for the battle they'll fight till it's done. They've plenty of power, they're men of the hour, they measure their line by the ton. They've got
got the stuff to make it tough for any conquerors who would be, but never could be. It's not the bunk, they've got the spunk to make all of
you. Hugh tells a great story about they wrote this song, and then they mentioned to Arthur that it was done, and they wanted to know what Judy's best vocal range was. And Arthur Freed said, oh, she's got a really good, try to keep it, you know, an octave a little over. And Hugh thought, oh, we've got two octaves in this song. And he said, but he wanted so much to hear her sing it that when Arthur arranged for them to demonstrate it for her, they went out to her home and she fell in love with the song. And they sang it to her once, and then she sang it right back at them. She had this amazing, and everybody with whom she worked has the same story, that, you know, she was Saul Chaplin, another great vocal arranger at Metro, with whom Judy worked on and off for, you know, 15, 16 years. He said, she was like a vacuum cleaner. You played her the song, and she gave it right back to you, which is great, because you didn't have to teach her.
Meet Me in St. Louis was released in 1944 and contains Hugh Martin's best-known songs, The Boy Next Door, The Trolley Song, and one of the most nostalgic and cherished of all Christmas wishes, Have Yourself a Merry Little Christmas.
We would write our songs separately. Ralph wrote words and music, and I wrote words and music. And so the songs Ralph wrote, because he had not worked as hard as I, he was very talented, but he just didn't work as hard. So his songs were ejected, and those three songs were actually all by me. I wrote the words and the music to all three of them.
Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light. Next year all our troubles will be out of sight.
There are very few movies for which songwriters have written three songs and all three of the songs turn out to be classics.
Right.
I mean, when you give them The Boy Next Door in the first 20 minutes, you give them The Trolley Song in the first 40 minutes, and you give them Have Yourself a Merry Little Christmas about an hour and a half in, that's just amazing songwriting.
Our troubles will be miles away. Again, as in olden days, happy golden days of yore, faithful friends who were near to us will be dear to us once more.
Ralph was enormously helpful, though. He was a good critic, a good idea man, a good research man. I mean, it was his research that led to The Trolley Song. He went to the library and found a little picture of a trolley in, from the period, and the caption under it was, clang, 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 went the jolly little trolley. And that prompted me to write The Trolley Song.
The use of repeated notes in the verse of The Boy Next Door is just so beautiful to me.
Now, that was Ralph's idea, too.
Was it?
You see, he was valuable, even though I lucked out with the song. But Ralph gave me some wonderful ideas. He said, why don't you put the address of the young lovers in the verse? I think it would be clever. And I was able to do that.
I live at 5135 Kensington Avenue, and he lives at 5133. How can I ignore the boy next door? I love him more than I can say.
Alec Wilder writes of The Boy Next Door, another of those quintessential Judy Garland standards. The Boy Next Door is undoubtedly Martin's best-known song. It's very much a standard and deserves to be. From a musician's point of view, it's a gem.
I used to think the states were 48, but there is one that really shouldn't rate. Too dry and too wet, too, I thought I'd let you know. It's got a reputation for its size, ho, 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 but that's the only claim I recognize. Too cold and too hot, too, it's really got to go back to Mexico. I'm tired of Texas.
I have one more thing to talk to you about, and this is this wonderful, funny song called I'm Tired of Texas.
Oh, I hope you're not from Texas. Oh, you are from Texas.
Yes, I am. But
well, you know, I got hate mail from that. It was reprinted in Life magazine, and I got letters threatening my life.
No, no.
Yes, I did. They said, we're coming to New York. We're going to kill you.
Well, I guess we're pretty ornery sometimes, we Texans.
You can be ornery. I wrote it when I was in basic training.
Oh, in Texas?
In Texas.
Well, no wonder.
I went to Camp Hood, which is now Fort Hood.
Of course. Well.
And I went in the middle of summer, and it was rough. It was so hot, and we all just passed out, you know, all right and left. But at least I got a good song out of it.
You certainly
everybody
did.
Sake, we hope it stays there, but they think they're the best. From the east to the west, they wouldn't give a hoot in Hades for the rest.
In El Paso, they sing basso, and they love to wrap your torso around a lasso. It's an old Texas custom to take them and bust them on the jaw, and it's no use to call the law.
I'm tired of Texas.